What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another American Truck Simulator video. My name is Moose78. Hopefully you guys are doing well today, by the way. And we're back at it with another episode of Stories from the Road. This is another trip from one of my live streams over there on Twitch. If you guys want to check me out over on Twitch, a link for my channel is down in the video description. So be sure to check that out. But if you like today's video, be sure to give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. Guys, we're going to cut on over to the footage, and we'll catch you at the end of the video. Back in Holland, so it's nice to see people, you know, put them in game and just kind of respect the work that was, you know, initially done. That's a pretty sharp looking truck, for sure. It should put us about 4 o'clock in the morning, which is okay. Where we get some, you know, kind of, not really nighttime driving in, but at least a little bit of dark time driving. Check Z Freight Marquette. All right, over here in Sacto, let's see. When Eddie's, oh boy. That's a place I definitely got to spend some time offline, kind of practicing backing into. Those places are a pain in the neck. To a sell goods. See, that is down. Oh, yeah, Santa Maria. Definitely. We'll grab that guy. Head back down to Walbert, grab some used packaging, and we'll truck on down to Santa Maria. That should be a nice little trip. Like the Eddies, like the little grocery stores. Which, you know, that kind of makes sense. It's kind of realistic. Those little grocery stores like that weren't necessarily, you know, made or designed for a, you know, 53-foot trailer and a, you know, full-size tractor. They were kind of made, you know, more so in mind and for the small, you know, city trucks, you know, box trucks or, you know, single axle day cabs and the little pup trailers. So must have us picking up at another Walbert. Yeah. So that's kind of the weird thing about some of these towns. I mean, like, look here in Sacramento, there's 1, 2, 3 Walberts all in the same city. Which, again, not incredibly unrealistic, but for the game, it'd be kind of nice to see them kind of mix it up a little bit. Maybe put some different warehouses or whatever in there. Maybe I can mix it up and turn my headlights on. Maybe I can do that. Yeah, like the biggest city close to me, there's probably 3-4 Walmarts in that town, plus like a, you know, Sam's Club. Aha, there it is. So I know there had to be a screen on the onboard computer that showed me the miles per hour, so go. Trailer's all the way over there, which shouldn't be too bad to get. There we Let's see, do we want to haul the one with the skirts? I will go with the one with the steelies, the white steelies. Back it just a little bit so I don't take out the front of the store. The utility trailer, when I tried backing under that last night, had a little bit of difficulty doing that, so we'll see how it does with the ball bash here. Looks like I can be able to get under that okay as long as I get lined up. Like the utility trailer, I could not get back underneath that. It like stopped right at the mud flaps and that was it. Have a quick screenshot, rightly quick. There we go. Check the manifest real quick. Use packaging, 36,000 pounds, going down to Santa Maria. Let's check the map real quick, see which way it has us going. And just going straight down the 5. See, do we want to go straight down the 5, or what do we want to do there? What do we want to do there? Could come over this way, catch 80. Go down the 580. And that way. Might do that. I think that's what we'll do. Then catch 152 down to the... Get on the 101 a little bit down in Santa Maria. And we are off. There we go. Make sure I get wide enough to get out of here. Not hit anything. There we go. Down to Santa Maria. Now, I haven't looked at the notes for Project West, so I'm not sure what all they've changed so far. So we'll just kind of keep an eye out and see if we notice anything different, I guess. I don't know, I like coming through these towns like this when it's, you know, first thing in the morning. I don't know why, just kind of cool, I guess. Kind of seeing the sunrise, you know, kind of there in the background. Not a huge amount of traffic out yet, but starting to pick up a little bit. So we're doing good on fuel, so... Or, you know, hopefully the fuel gauge is accurate. Yeah, it seems like it is. Spin around before I go around the curve here. Oops. Almost made a wrong turn. Almost. One thing I'm kind of messing around with, if you guys have watched, you know, any of the streams recently or, you know, any of my videos, like anytime a scene loads in the game, it kind of lags out, kind of bad, kind of stutters. I went into my NVIDIA Inspector and I changed the amount of pre-rendered frames from like the app, where it's application controlled. So I think I have it set to like 8. And it seems like that's, you know, knock on wood, that's kind of helped a little bit. So I'm just going to kind of keep an eye on it, see how it goes. See if that is actually going to help. Hopefully it does. Seems like it's running a little bit smoother. I haven't noticed as, you know, much of that, you know, kind of lag and kind of stutter when, like, new scenes load. But if that works, man, I'm going to be pretty happy with that. Yeah, Vince, one nice thing that Twitch did, I think last Friday, actually, was you can upload, before you could upload like 3.5 megabits per second max if you're a non-partnered streamer like I am, to where now it's like 6. So that's pretty big, pretty significant change. I'm kind of glad they did. I don't know why they haven't done that before. So maybe they'll kind of loosen up some of those requirements and stuff like that, and allow the little streamers like me to have a little bit better quality stream without being partnered. I don't know if they were maybe losing some people to YouTube gaming, where there's really no requirements. You don't have to be partnered or anything like that over there, and you can stream, you know, as high as a bit rate as you want to go. But I don't like Twitch a lot better. Just the user interface is a lot better. You know, the chat functions are a lot better. And there's just more, kind of apps and add-ons for Twitch streaming out there as opposed to YouTube gaming, so. That's one I always forget about, is Beam. See, there it lagged a little bit, but it was just, you know, kind of momentary. It seems like it, you know, bounced back pretty quick, so. Kind of see how it goes. I gotta say though, I'm digging this Volvo. This thing is nice and just kind of smooth, kind of like, you know, been saying, it's nice and clean. But the engine sounds are pretty spot on. Not too loud. Looks really good pulling the aero trailers with the side skirts and everything. Right, turn my headlights off here in a second. I switched back to just the final version, no edits or anything like that, of the Escape weather mod, and I gotta say I'm pretty pleased with it. You know, it's not too bright, it's not oversaturated, and I'm not having the issues of the game being real dark and then getting real bright like I was with the Peterbilt weather mod. So that's kind of nice. Over here, let these boys out. Coming up on us there. Looks like they're gonna let us over. And it seems like it's a little bit darker in the interior view, but I don't know if that's just how it's set up, or maybe that's, you know, how the glass materials are set up on the truck, but I don't think it looks too bad at all. And there is going to be some tint on the windows, so it's going to be a little bit darker anyway, so. Too bad a start to the day. Was on time. That's always good. That's like a first, actually. Ooh. Blow past my exit here, looking around, not paying attention. It's all right, though. Got plenty of braking power. Cut over, do a little bit of two-lane driving, then should be back on the four lanes. I've seen they're still updating the beta, which is pretty good. I actually had my first bug the other day. I was just kind of messing around. And then I can't remember exactly where it was at, but just fell right through the interstate. But it seems like they've been pretty quick to get some of the bugs fixed and things like that, so it's always good. So I'm gonna slow down just a little bit. That, and we got a turn coming up, so. Much a straight shot down to, yeah, down to Santa Maria on the 101. Right there at 58, and we're good to go. And for those of you guys that may have missed the announcement, the East Genesis end dump that I was using there a couple weeks back and did a mod review on over, I should say a mod preview on, over on my YouTube channel, that is going to be released this Friday. Initially, it was going to be a Steam release, but the authors have decided not to upload it to Steam, but it will be uploaded to you know, some of the more popular mod sites out there. I can imagine like atsmods.lt, modsats.com, I think it's modland.net. I don't know, that's one that I just started checking out, so I don't have the URL etched in my mind yet, but yeah, definitely be looking out for that sometime Friday. I think you guys are really to like that trailer. And of course, if you're watching this later on YouTube, chances are it's already been released, so... That's kind of the funny thing about, you know, recording the streams and then uploading to YouTube later on is, you know, some of the information's a little bit dated and stuff like that, and people are probably going, what the hell is he talking about? Thing's been released for like a month. So I've been trying to put like little disclaimers down in the description for those folks that read the descriptions. If I'm talking about anything, any dated information, this is probably why. But you know, if any news stories, you know, come up between now and then, you know, I'll try to get those done as soon as possible. Not that there's ever a whole lot of breaking news for the game or anything like that. You know, I think like the last biggest thing was obviously the rescale. Which I think over the last couple weeks, I've explored more of the map. Take a look real quick. Yeah, I've probably explored a lot more of the map just over the last couple weeks than I have, you know, since the rescale's been out. Like, I think before I might have had maybe 10% in the few months the rescale had been out, so... And it has been kind of nice just running the, you know, vanilla map and, you know, checking everything out. But it's also nice to have the map mods in there to, you know, kind of add to the experience and kind of liven up the world a little bit. Kind of break up the monotony and, you know, kind of keep that replayability up. You know, that's the greatest thing about this game is, you know, the modding community. Always, you know, kind of a fresh supply of stuff out there. And plus, being able to mod the game a little bit, I can kind of freshen up some of the trucks and kind of change them up just a little bit to kind of make them a little bit newer, a little bit more unique. Which that's one thing I've been working on a little bit more is getting back into Zmodeler, and I still need to crack open Blender and get a little bit more familiar with that. You know, there's a wheel pack that I want to do that I'm probably going to end up doing in Blender. I know one of the guys over there, it's Half-Ass Gaming, has a pretty good tutorial on how to convert wheels over to the new setup. Well, it was new back, I think, in 1.2. But how the wheels are all separated out now, the hub, the nuts, and caps, and all that stuff. I don't want to convert over some of the old wheels from Holland, you know, some Alcoa, some Peterbilt wheels, some Kenworth wheels, Volvo wheels, and get that working with 50Kata's real tire mod. I don't think it'll be too extremely difficult. Shouldn't be too extremely time consuming, just kind of learning the process on how to do that. Shenanigans, that's... Ah, he's coming up behind me. That's the first ticket I've had for a while. First speeding ticket, anyway. And about the time I get out here, these cars are all going to speed up. Well, maybe not, that truck's up there. Kind of blocking for me a little bit. Come on, Jeep. Come on now. Okay, good. Thought that was my exit there for a second. It's like, ah. Room the cruise and good to go. Been going for about an hour. How's everyone doing? Hopefully everyone's having a good day today. If you are just joining, welcome. Thanks for stopping by and hanging out. I do appreciate it. Yeah, it seems like that little trick I did at Inspector is working a little bit. Whereas before, you know, I'd be going along, I'd be getting, you know, 70, 80 frames, and all of a sudden it would drop down to like 5. Santa Maria discovered. Now, this is one of the cooler little towns in the game, especially since the rescale. I can't remember, honestly, I can't remember if it was in the game before the rescale, but I know I've heard a lot of good things about it since the rescale, so. Oh. Rev it up to about 6,000 there. Assuming that's the place we're delivering to. I know I picked up at one of those Walberts recently. Nope. No, it is not. I don't think I've ever delivered to one like that. So I was kind of hoping that that was going to be the place. Don't think I can go through the gas station to make my turn, so I'll just go up here to the intersection. Silly GPS. Okay. That shouldn't be too bad. Just gotta find the little icon. There it is in front of me. I'm using the immersive icons pack out there on the Steam Workshop. That way I don't have that big green kind of floaty thing. All right. Give this backing up thing another go. So where do they want it? Right there in the middle of that. Aw, oh, son of a biscuit eater. The utility trailer's gotta be right there. It's all right. See how it goes. Kind of do like I did. Gotta turn my Jake brake off. It's kind of what I need to do. There it is. So I'm almost kind of thinking. I'm going to have to back. It's probably going to be easier if I back up just a little bit and turn around and come at it from the other way. That way I'm not trying to fight for space with this utility trailer. As good as I wanted to do, but shoot, I'll take that. I will take that. Actually, ain't too bad at all. Now, of course, you know, in real life, I wouldn't do that, but all right, guys, that's going to wrap it up for another episode of Stories from the Road. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed it. If so, just give the video a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple of videos, and consider subscribing now. And if you want to catch me over on Twitch, link for my Twitch channel is down in the video description. So be sure to check that out. Come over and say hi. We always have a good time over there. But guys, until the next time, stay safe out there. Take care, and we'll be seeing you.